Hello and welcome. Now we'll go to Rome. We'll be 50 kilometres north of Rome, roughly, or a bit more, but there's the town of Falerii, Novi, a walled settlement, and beside, flanking that town, would be the part of the Via Amerina. Now this is part of a much larger road system, ancient road system in Italy, but so we'll have a look at just this area. It actually crosses a river, but the bridge is gone. But so we'll start out sort of on that road and we'll just look at pieces beside the road. Now indeed the Romans may have treated older parts of this, so just be aware that as the Romans come in, they didn't necessarily create it all. It might have been there already and then they've worked over it, if you know what I mean. Enjoy. Just to get a bit of a bearing on where we are, the write up here is in Italian, bit of a map though here with some further photographs here on this roadway, and just another one here. I have not been in here. We are going to have a look in here. The rock, you can see the way the rock is kind of scraped actually there. Now entering in we have you can see the fine finishing work in here. I don't know what to say about that. And interesting scrapings on the wall here, and to the around, just basically having a look around at this. You can see the fine finishing work, the Roman, just perfectly smooth. And that all of it would have been like this. I don't know whether that's algae or not, but further up you can see the red on the ceiling. You can see the finishing still there, some of the finishing work. There appears to be a little bit of a bow in there. So we were just putting a ruler across this part here, but now we'll just discuss something with the ceiling here, is that once again we're noticing the striations through here, the markings and hash marks through the stone, and the possibility that that is there because of, as you can see, the finishing up here. So those hash marks may have been used for this sort of plaster stone that was up there. This part here may be an indication of a blocking mechanism for the doorway, which is, we are in the entrance right here, and I am crouched down. Okay, we're still on this roadway and there are these nooks and crannies along the sides. This one here is starting to look quite complicated. Sort of old stairway coming in, dropping in. Really quite strange, no doubt about it. Just the angles in here, as you can see, the angular way this, and then just further down this clear-cut doorway simply in the rock face. Finishing seems to be all, virtually all gone out of this. It would have, these no doubt would have been finished in their day. One of the
creation is what you called it. This.
Now, one feature here is that this entranceway here goes up here, and we'll try and make the climb here one-handed and everything else. Do a bit of a spin around. There is a little bit of a ledge here to walk across, and we have actually the doorway here, the doorstep type thing, precarious, and no entry into here. and a bit of a look inside. Oh, mate, come up here. So, now this is probably the reason why it is blocked, the doorway, because you can see in the ceiling the designs now on the plaster.
Oh, wow.
The red dot in the center, and the markings. I'll try and zoom in. Okay, so now we have a better light. So once again, looking at the design in here, a very intricate design, and you can see colouring over here as well. You can see the fracturing in the rock here over time. Do you mind just go to that fracturing? You can see how the cavity is quite fractured here also around major cracking going through. Thank you. Yeah. We'll go down. In here we have these pits. Let's go to the back. And we'll just get a look at the entire back piece. Oh, look at the blue.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so, and then looking over to, yes, and the blue in here. Yeah, super interesting. Here is another perspective of the bottom layer, and here is a perspective of the top. One of the things I've noticed here is that further up, there's this really odd, certainly don't have explanations for this, but this ring, there is a ring in the rock over here. And then we'll just take a wider view for a moment. And so this would be part of a roadway, old Roman roadway. A bit of a look at the sign here and the plaque running down. And then this part of the signs on the ground. And then coming in, all sorts of blocks. Just fascinating, really, this wall with this sort of channel running down it. It's not, well, it has, anyway, and then all these lines on the wall. Within, just off the road here a little bit, the sign is just there. The blocks, you can see this, a lot of workmanship into this block here, and within it you can see that's actually metal, so holding it together. And I've just cleared off this space here, you can see another piece of metal sort of holding the construction together, the stone assisting to hold it together. The lines up here that are within the single rock face are repeated just in here. You have this rock face in here, and then in the middle of it, and it's a vertical wall going up, you have this space up within here also. This is that area, and then these strange configuration here, this sort of pit. A wider look. Okay, around this way, another wall construction in here. Really, it is quite something to be here. These blocks are massive, they're building the construction. And one thing to note is that it's just beautiful in here with the rivers flowing through this gully and down. And then meanwhile, there is this ancient and extensive construction and blocks, massive really, going right through. Yeah, this could totally be natural,
yeah.
But at the same time it looks quite uniform, and coming up here and there's around this bend here and then up just this pathway through here, it kind of looks a bit like it's cut in a way. Here's another one here. There does seem to be a bit of a uniformity to this. Here is another sign for the area that we are currently in. And here is the plaque with the writing, late 1st century BC in there, among other aspects, according to the official documentation of this these Roman constructions within this forest. Okay, this is the board, a bit of a descriptor as to this area here. Whether completely factual or not, it's another story. We're going to come up into this area here, but just noticing this hole in the wall here, which is actually going to lead through. So coming around this way, and a little mushy right there. So we're going to come in this beautiful archway, and here we can see that hole, and you can see actually the detail in here, the fascia around here. Interesting here with this doorway that this time we have the two orbs, the two circles, or pointing the camera, the two circles within the stonework right at the doorway here. And again, as we saw in the site earlier today, this configuration around the doorway, this you can see the similar configuration in Egypt. And now there's this area here. Now we will proceed through. There is the decayed steps here. This recess, it actually goes right above. There's a grating on there so people don't fall through. And then we can come through this way and in. And all right, so this part here, there is a central part to it right here. And what have we got? Okay, and then this room recedes in. We can see the extent of it here, and we will come across and we can see the extent with a bat. We'll pick that bat up.
Little fella.
We'll just get a close-up of this cricket within here also.
That guy is business-sized. For what we saw today than the stuff we saw a little bit ago because of this.
Yes.
Right.
Oh, that's definitely a match. Definitely a match. Yeah.
Yeah. And then...
Actually, look, you can see the extra working here as well.
Uh-huh.
And also within here, actually, when we look closely, we can see a vesica pisces-like design in the center of it.
Absolutely.
Right there.
Mm-hmm.
We will go across to the other one and see if there's any detail. And in this one, it does not appear so. Well, there's nothing that stands out like that.
Yeah. Do we have that?
Yeah. Do we have that? Yes, see we this? Have yeah. the keystone-like prominence out of the side of this... out of the cut stone here, hewn from the rock.
These marks,
coming in.
Striations that we've been noticing.
Yes.
Now these look way more similar to the ones that
they do. Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Touch.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because they, you see them running for
yes.
Meters.
Yes. So they run down the rock, it appears. Yes, as they do at the other site as well. As has been pointed out here at this doorway, we have this channel through the rocks, and this would definitely be from the water that has come down because of the recessed opening up here, coming in and running down and making that uniformity into the rock. This side is pretty wild.
Maybe it was upright.
Yeah, this huge part is broken down. You can see in here the right-angled nature of the cut, and also down here, now this section that's rounded as well. Now there is this region in here, and we will come in for a bit of a look. And again, we're going to see the doorway, pattern around the doorway coming across this side, the same pattern, and also the beautiful cornice-like work around here also. Stunning, really. Also, we're going to see this arch, and then down here also, although, okay, maybe this is a crack in the rock, actually. It looks like a crack in the rock. And then around this way, getting a bit of an idea for where we are. And then we'll come through here. Again, this recess going up. And you get all the noises with the video like this. And then again, this is a similar configuration to the last one we saw with this recess in here. Although, the striations.
Oh, yeah.
Now we have these striations really going from the top to the bottom. Yes.
They seem somewhat thicker in here.
So let's go from the top and then just going down, 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 down. They're huge in here. All right. Yeah, beautiful. Yeah. And then the recesses in the walls. We're going to come across this side. Wow, it's really, really, really,
really rough
is the word I'm looking for. Okay. This green, yes, possibly indicates a copper within the rock, although possibly we don't know actually. That could be. Here is a board. Also, I like to include this to give a bit of an indication as to where we are.
It's adorned.
This one seems less adorned. We're just around the corner now from the prior ones, really along this rock face, to get a bit of an idea here. Some of the scenery here, all these strewn blocks down here. There is a river, this beautiful river running. We can hear the water flowing down there. We're going to go in here right now and have a look at this. Again, up above, coming in, we see that green again. Strangely enough, the green is in the center, just as we saw on the last one. So the green is in the center as we walk in. Now, if we go to the sides, we don't see the green. We don't see the green, we don't see the green. We don't see the green. We do see all this. We'll do a 360. Three high, three high. The only place with the green is in the center here. As you walk in, that's the first thing you see. Very strange. The ceiling is rough. There's even this quite prominent stone coming out in that case there. We're now entering the first one to see if there's any green in here. We're just sort of backtracking a bit. This is the one with the Vesica Pisces-like design up here. And we're just going to go in to see if there's any green straight away in the center. There is. I just saw a bat. Okay. There is. So here is that green again in the center. You watch my camera, maybe. So the green is in the center. Now, when we go around, again, we don't see green. Both of us, we're not seeing it, are we? We're not seeing it, yeah. Okay. All right, so the green, for whatever reason, is as you come in. Maybe it has something to do with sunlight coming in the doorway. Maybe not. We were just around the corner here. Here is the sign. And now this prominence, the roadway, central roadway going up. Walking up here, you can see the little prominences to the side, the prominent stones to the side. And yes, yes, within here there are track-like marks also. We're coming up to another one here. Recesses everywhere.
Okay, this is not a query. It's the same thing.
Yes, on the rock.
That's not a query.
Yeah. Yes. As to what it is, but yeah. Again, a repeat. So just in here, this rock, very straight, the very fine striations on it. Here in the rocks, you see those marks. You see it again here, possibly used to join the rocks together. This is the roadway here. There's all manner of cavities in the rocks beside the road. And let's go and have an investigation up here, where Robin tells us that we should have a little gawk.
With painted decor.
Awesome.
You'll see.
We're going to have to make the way through over this part. You can see here is a good example of the plastering, where some of it has come off. And then here you can see the redness already, so the red and coming straight in.
Green.
Yeah, the green straight in the front. Oh, well, it's sort of in the front as we come in. The red here, yes. Wow. So the painting, yeah,
wow.
it's actually still there. The red window, sort of like design around here. Jump to the other side, and it keeps going. Really interesting. You can see on here the plaster working actually. You can see the actual working of the plaster, the workmanship, trowel work within here. Wow, so this rocks. So here is the example of the triptych configuration. And without having been in here before, again, all these recesses into the floor. In this case, in many cases, there is this this step down part before it goes into the main chamber. Again here, although they're not consistent heights, but there is a step down part as if you could put a covering on here. It's, yes, in here, step down part. And in here, a step down part. There's a bone down here from probably human. I'm joking about that.
And, no. Yeah, it could be, these maybe something holding something, like closing something.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Along here.
Like rings.
So yeah.
Metal ring, right?
Yeah, yeah. Something. Yeah, as is being talked about here, these spaces for honey, herbs, or wine, storage foods, maybe over the winter time when
beer.
We don't, there is no, yeah, beer, when there is no produce, so, you know, that possibility of storage of foods over the winter period in particular, when there is, when the harvest is over. Across this side here, and we have a person, one of the crew here, Josh, looking through. So now is the time to actually progress across here and check this out.
Yeah,
let's have a look at this for a moment. It's kind of amusing with the foot dangling through this here and the face here.
Yeah, so telephone, you won't see anything, anyway.
Having a look across the road again, the road here with this boulder right in the middle of the road. Maybe it's fallen down, actually. That's probably, that would have to be the logical explanation for that. So the boulder would have fallen down. So now he didn't get through here. Having a look at another one of these. They're all different. They all vary. And now, curiously, there are holes to the sides of these doorways in this case. Now, coming up this way, and wow,
look at this. It's worth noting that even these pools or these trenches have the striations on them.
You can right,
especially see it from that side on this wall of it.
Yeah, all right,
so that would suggest that there were plaster, these were plastered as well.
Yeah,
so. All of
so,
these, they're very prominent right here.
And now coming through this way, there is a bit of a rock here, but so, and just a bit of a look here, and this is the place where the feet were and the head were. It's extensive. Taking a bit of a close-up around here, just such curious places, curious cuts into the rock, so extensive. All right, so this one here, in this case, there is a triangular form. And it's actually, you can see the finishes right there. There's even some red paint, it looks like, still on there, on the finish. And here, it looks like some yellow paint still remains. Now, one thing about this little area, and I'm traversing these things and trying not to fall in, is that you can see the finish, then you can see this area here, which may have been to lay things across with this prominence here, and it sort of comes across here, and then you go down one, and then it's like there's a second layer, there could be a second layer in here. So one layer could go across here, and then a sort of second layer down there, possibly, potentially. Now this part over here is freaky.
I'm just mind-boggled by all this.
But I know what you mean.
Walking across here. Now this one's interesting. We don't get a lot of this. So with the stone in the middle, it may have been part of a pillar, but also when it gets a bit like this, it's a reminder of altars in the center. Having a look around, mosquitoes here are overpowering some of the color. The finishing left in there, the part here for a potential covering, angular parts to it, as well as the rounded.
And this type of road design was definitely Roman. I mean, you know, this is definitely
Roman.
Roman
road, and if you go to Perugia.
But even with the shape, like this type of shaping is
So this five-sided block right here, as Robin's pointing out. Here is one of those openings from a top view, and we'll have a look down here for a moment. Wow, all around here actually. So down in the gully here and through the gully, these are these lower parts that are being mentioned here and supporting supports down here for this lower wall, the road up here. Now proceeding into this area here and having a look, and we have some torches in here. We can see the definition with the doorway at the top, and let's proceed through. There are supports, but they're not doing anything here. The scaffolding has dropped, and wow, look at the finishing.
Yeah.
So here's the some of the finishing just sitting here. The plaster here, you can see the real definition on the
in here. Possibly not plaster. I'm thinking this is more like a
tiles.
You see how this?
Yeah. Another thing to note here is that this is all sloped. It's not level. This wall is not level. We'll just pan across here if you don't mind watch. We'll do a 360. There's old scaffold in here and around. And for whatever reason, this whole thing is sloped. Okay, let's go.
I think.
So the bricks right here.
We don't want this.
Another side up here. So there would have been probably a bridge going across here, as is pointed out by Robin. Construction up here and then across to the side, and we were just up in this region over here just before.
Yeah, there's nothing quite like this that we've seen today.
No, we did, but
I mean there were some that were kind of similar, but not
back up here there were.
See this?
There, yes.
This is more